Nothing quite screams exotic, rare, and probably endangered, like a wide-eyed lemur. These unusual primates are brimming with personality, and their unique method of locomotion makes them highly distinctive and charismatic. It's obvious why someone might gravitate towards keeping a lemur as a pet. But are lemurs legal to own as pets, and do people actually own them? Yes and yes. If you are in the United States, depending on the state you live in, you can legally own a lemur as long as you purchase it within the state you live. However, there are some misconceptions about doing so, and misinformation is present on various websites throughout the internet. Which brings us to our first claim about owning pet lemurs. True or false? You need to obtain a special license to own a pet lemur. False. While there are only a small number of states that allow the private ownership of lemurs and other primates as pets, as of mid-2021, in most cases, no special permit or license is required to own one at the state level. One exception to this is the state of Florida, which requires a Class 3 permit. Also be aware that while a species might be legal to own in the state, they can be regulated, restricted, or banned in certain cities, towns, and other jurisdictions. True or false? All lemur species that are kept as pets are endangered. False. While most lemur species are endangered or critically endangered, including the wildly popular ringtail lemur and the less common ruffed lemurs, the brown lemur, with the scientific name Ulemur fulvus, is listed as of August 2021 as vulnerable by the IUCN. This is one step away from being endangered, however. True or false? It's hard to feed a pet lemur. False. Kinda. Feeding pet lemurs is not technically hard, unless you consider feeding pets like green iguanas and parrots difficult. In captivity, lemurs eat a lot of the same foods that you do, without the cooking and junk foods, of course. A good lemur diet consists of fruit, leafy greens, and various vegetables that can be found at your local Walmart, as well as a nutritionally complete commercial primate biscuit that can be purchased via the internet. Collecting leaves and other outdoor edible plants can provide a great supplement to their diet as well. This isn't really hard to achieve, although sadly, people are misinformed on how to properly feed primates and think it's perfectly fine to feed them pizza and ice cream. True or false? Lemurs are hard to breed in captivity. False. While some species of lemur are not kept and bred in captivity, such as the sportive lemur species, other species of lemur, such as the wildly popular ringtail lemur, and other members of the genus Ulemur, have adapted well to captivity. These lemurs are propagated successfully by zoos, as well as private owners, and they seem to adapt well to captivity when their needs are met. True or false? Lemurs are aggressive and can attack their owners. True. Ringtail lemurs are well known among exotic pet owner circles to be heavily prone to aggressive behavior when they are hand-raised and socialized with humans. It generally starts between the ages of 2 to 6 years, around the time they hit sexual maturity. Sadly, lemurs that have not been exposed to other lemurs while they are developing imprint on humans instead of lemurs, viewing them as both potential mates and competition. This leads to aggression towards their owners or strangers, although this varies on an individual basis. It also needs to be mentioned that the rough lemurs are reported by owners to be substantially less aggressive compared to ringtailed lemurs, but potential owners of any primate should prepare themselves for potential aggression regardless. This might sound pretty bad. However, this phenomenon also occurs with hand-raised parrots and other birds, albeit with less severe injuries that can occur. Even domesticated animals like dairy bulls can become extra aggressive when hand-raised. A preferable option to keeping lemurs is to raise at least 2 animals, or even a colony, in a similar fashion to zoos, which will have an improved outcome. True or false? Keeping a lemur as a pet harms them in the wild. This is false. There is currently no evidence that owning captive bred lemurs outside of their native country affects lemurs in the wild. This is not true, however, for lemurs that are kept as pets in Madagascar. Lemurs are commonly removed from the wild to be displayed within hotels to attract tourists, to be held as personal pets, and for other reasons. However, there is no established trade of lemurs in this nation. Rather, the privately owned lemurs are most often taken from the wild by the person who owns them. This includes lemur species that are not kept in captivity in other countries at all. Owning lemurs in countries like the United States or the United Kingdom doesn't require wild-caught lemurs, and there is no evidence of a systemic trade exporting lemurs into the exotic pet trade. In fact, it is highly illegal for wild lemurs to be taken as pets, both by locals as well as internationally. The best way to help wild lemurs would be to donate to the reputable organizations that are striving to conserve them, and to not take photos with lemurs being held as props if you happen to be traveling in Madagascar. It should also be noted that some businesses in Madagascar that possess lemurs may aid in their conservation. True or false, lemurs are wild animals and cannot be domesticated. False. Because there is no universally agreed upon scientific definition of what domestication is and which animal should be considered as such, domestication has become an umbrella term to describe a multitude of human and plant or animal relationships that involve some level of genetic adaptation to human-controlled settings that occurs over a number of generations. Primates, just like other organisms, evolve when there are selective pressures or environmental agents that reduce or increase their reproductive success. Due to this, in theory, lemurs could have some level of adaptation to captivity if they are part of a multi-generational breeding program, where those which are best adapted to captivity and comfortable with the presence of humans have the best breeding success and pass those traits to their offspring. These likely subtle changes wouldn't mean that any primate species with their complex social structures and cognitive abilities would be less challenging to care for, however. And last but not least, true or false, lemurs are hard to care for. Speaking of how hard lemurs are to care for, that's our next often repeated claim, not just about lemurs, but other exotic pets as well. And the only proper response to this statement is, it depends. Many species of animals are often claimed to be hard to care for, everything from primates to foxes to sugar gliders and even reptiles, fish, and hamsters, and certain breeds of dog. How much time, money, and space are you willing to dedicate to a pet? Lemurs need spacious enclosures. In most cases, they should be housed with at least one other lemur, and you'll have to prepare a fresh diet for them often. You'll probably have to give up vacations, as it is hard to find someone who will care for your lemurs, and you'll be in charge of their mental well-being for the next potential 20 plus years. With the right environment, lemurs can be simple to care for, but they can cause more problems when raised alone in a small environment. So do lemurs make bad pets? This too can be true and false. Again, with the right enclosure, social environment, nutrition, and the fortune of being located near a veterinarian who will see primates, lemurs can make excellent pets. It's all about knowing what to expect of the animal and only acquiring them if you can meet their specific needs. That's it for this video, but if you want to see more exotic animal related content, be sure to subscribe. And thanks for watching!